Hey guys, I'm back again with another r/pro revenge, and this one is titled, Don't Send Nudes on Your Company Phone. If you do, don't tell anyone about it. If you do, make sure you don't tell someone who doesn't like you. If you do, delete the nudes before you hand in your phone to the IT department. Let's get right into it. So I used to work with this man named Michael. Michael was a sycophantic yes man who had no real skills required for a job, but faked it well for a few years. When I was hired, Michael was the regional manager. Though he was very friendly to me in the days leading up to me joining, he was apparently telling all of the employees that I was only hired to come in and clean house, that I was not to be trusted, and that everyone should go to only him for everything. It took a few months for people to realize that I wasn't the monster he set me up to be and that I was there to help. Once the employees knew I wasn't a bad guy, they came to me for everything. Michael did not like this. Skip forward a few years. There's been some pettiness and some clashing, but Michael and I are at a point where we can work together civilly and generally stay out of one another's way. Unbeknownst to me, Michael was very much not doing his job, and the company decided to hire someone to replace him, Charles. However, because my company believes in second chances, Michael was allowed to step down to a lesser role. Charles came in, he and I clicked right away, and Michael faded into the background. Now, Michael's wife was not very impressed with his demotion. Some bad shit went down, fights were had, and finally a divorce was announced. Michael decided that at his ripe old age of 45, he was going to jump right into the online dating world. He had a new date every 2 or 3 days, was constantly bragging about the girls he was going out with, but never seemed to realize that he only ever had first dates. No one apparently wanted a second. During this freewheeling free-for-all, Michael apparently met a girl on Plenty of Fish. They hadn't met, but were talking and flirting all day, every day. After about 2 weeks of POF girl, Michael started complaining about money. He'd been on the phone with some company or another, paying a late bill or setting up a payment plan. He would ask constantly if we could order pizza for one of the teams and then eat that. He started looking pretty braggled. One of Michael's female friends from work started complaining to me that Michael was always asking her for money. When I asked why, she said Michael was sending money and paying bills for this Plenty of Fish girl. I was a little surprised. They'd never met. He didn't have much money to begin with, and the lending money is always a weird situation. The friend later told me that Michael had sent some suggestive photos to the girl, and that she was holding them over his head. This didn't really sit right with me. I mean, he's not married, he's not famous, he's not high-powered, so what could this girl ruin in his life? The only thing he has is this job. That's when it clicked. Plenty of Fish girl had to be someone from work. Around this time, I got a spam email telling me that the sender had explicit photos and videos of me, had been tracking my phone, knew what type of porn I watched, and hacked into my camera to watch me while I watched it. Such videos and pictures do not exist, and I am not a grubby teenager. If I'm going to watch porn, I'm watching it on my TV and making a night of it. The sender threatened to release the evidence if I didn't send $700 to some account they had. I knew right away it was spam, so I gave my phone and computer to IT to make sure there were no viruses. After getting the all clear, I decided to have some fun. I went into Michael's office, which he shared with two other managers, and shut the door. I told them that I was really freaked out that someone was blackmailing me and didn't know what to do. I gave Michael my phone so he could read the email, and his face turned white. He looks up at me, eyes wide, and whispers, "Oh my God, you too?" I asked what he was talking about, and he told me that someone had stolen pictures from his phone and was threatening him and that he'd already sent them money. I kept a straight face and said, "Oh my God, that's horrible. You should give your phone and your computer to IT to see if it's a virus and if they can track anything down." The man jumped right the F up. He bolted into IT, told them he thought he had a virus on his phone, and handed it over. I about died. Over that weekend, we received an email asking us to bring in any company-issued phones or computers for an antivirus update. I didn't think much of it, made sure I had my stuff, and reported to work on Monday morning. When I went to turn in my stuff, my manager laughed and said it wasn't necessary. I asked why. Apparently, the email had been ruse so that Michael would bring in his equipment. When IT searched his company phone that day, he asked them if he had a virus. They found pictures, videos, you name it, of Michael. They looked at the texts and emails and realized it wasn't spam, and that the name on the email account he had sent money to was shockingly similar to the name of one of our employees. Michael had been finessed, catfished, bamboozled by an employee. He was fired that day for misuse of company equipment. If you hadn't tried to get me fired 3 years ago, Michael, I wouldn't have effed with you over what I knew was spam, and you'd probably still have a job. Thank you guys for watching. Please comment below and let me know if there's any other subreddits you guys would like me to make videos on, and also like the video and please subscribe.